Hey guys, in today's video, we are checking out a new lens made by Makey or Maker. They were generous enough to send this out for review. This is another manual 25mm f1.8. Let's check out how it comes packaged. Here is the box that the lens comes in. Makey branding, pretty typical of what you see from Makey packaging, 25mm f1.8. This is an APS-C lens and multi-coated. There's a nice picture of it on the front. Around the back, you have another picture of it. Looks very similar to the Makey 35mm f1.7. And you have some specs, so 5 groups, 7 elements. So there we go. Let's open this up. You have the same little lens bag that you get with most Makey products. Some rain jacket material. You get a little microfiber cloth in a Ziploc pouch. The product guarantee card, some silica gel, and the lens itself. So it's packaged nicely with some cardboard. And here it is. So very compact, and in design, it looks very similar to a lens that I've already reviewed. It reminds me of the 28mm from Makey, reminds me of the 35 as well. The newer and Makey model lenses look pretty similar. They're actually made by the same company, just under different brands. So let's check this out. Makey logo, multi-coated. The minimum focusing distance is 0.25 of a meter, 49mm filter thread, and 1.825. You got Makey logo on the side, and not much else. So you have an aperture here on the bottom that goes from f1.8 to f16. Smooth and declicked, decently stiff. You can see the aperture opening and closing there in the middle. And then here is your focusing ring with a window on the front. You get a fair amount of focus range. You can see that's a little bit more than a full half turn. So a lot of range, which is nice. And you could see that that front barrel does move as you focus it. So you'll have a little bit of focus breathing most likely with this thing. So very lightweight, well constructed. It looks like it's all metal around the back, metal mount, no electronic connections. Again, this is a manual lens and it's APS-C only, so you could see how small that back cutout is. So let's put this on the A6000 and see how it looks. So here is the lens mounted on my A6000. As you could see, it is nice and compact. In fact, let me collapse it to show you what it looks like. It's about the size of the 16-50 kit lens. You can see around the front, it looks nice on the camera. The front lens element is pretty small on these 25mm lenses. But there you are. I'd say it matches the body quite well. I do like the silver ring around the front. It is very similar to most of the other 25mm lenses out there. All metal construction, it feels pretty solid. So let's take a look at some sample photos and videos using this lens. So that is it for the sample photos and videos. This lens is very easy to use.
I like the focus ring. It gives you that perfect level of adjustability where it's not too touchy sensitive and it's not like you're spinning over and over and over again just to get something in shot. Overall, the image quality was good and it reminded me a lot of the Makey and the newer 35mm f1.7 lens, just the way that it's built and the way that it performed. I have to say, from a usefulness standpoint, it's up to you as to which focal length you prefer. Personally, I like the 35mm focal length a little bit better just because it's more helpful when you're trying to do portraits outside. For street photography, it is a little bit nicer. This is kind of a semi-wide angle lens, even on a crop sensor, but you can use it for general photography. It is useful indoors, and you could still get decent portraits with it as long as you're a little bit closer to your subject. One thing that I do think they could improve is to make the aperture control a little bit more stiff. That way it's less prone to accidentally being bumped as you're trying to focus, because this is a very small lens, so if you have bigger hands and fingers, it's pretty easy to accidentally bump it when you're trying to focus. But beyond that, very little to complain about with this lens. And that's really going to be it for this quick review. Hope you guys enjoyed it and learned something. I am looking forward to comparing this lens to a new 25mm lens that's exciting. Well, for me anyway, it's a little bit faster and it's brand new. So look out for that video in the near future. As always, thank you guys for watching. Thanks for all of your likes, comments, and support. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.